Let's go to BamaInsider.com, Rivals Network of Websites. Kyle Henderson, I hope you're having a great day. Welcome into the game in T-Town.
Hey, I always appreciate you having me on the show. It's really good to talk to you.
It is, and I appreciate you giving us some insight here. Let's set up the Elite 11 for those who may not cover the event the way that you covered it this past weekend. Just kind of set the stage and help us understand more about the Elite 11.
Yeah, absolutely. So the Elite 11 finals took place this weekend at Redondo Beach Union High School, which is in Redondo Beach, California, and it featured 24 of the nation's top rising quarterbacks. Now, what does that mean? The top rising quarterbacks are the top quarterbacks across the country going into the class of 2019. So you guys have, big-time guys like Bo Nix, Paul Tyson, Talia Tungo-Vailoa, Sam Howell, who's committed to Florida State, big guys of this caliber, and they're all getting coached up by some of the best coaches in the business out in California. The lead coach is Trent Dilfer, and they're all vying for a spot to compete at the Nike opening, which will take place at the end of June. And in fact, Talia Tungo-Vailoa, who we can talk about, just was selected as one of the top final 11 quarterbacks to compete at the Nike opening, just like his brother Tua did a couple years ago. So it's a big-time high school event, but they also bring college counselors who are past Elite 11 alumni. For example, Jalen Hurts, Tua Tungo-Vailoa were at the event, along with Auburn's Jared Stidham. So those guys play a role in their counselors for the young guys. They help them with, kind of off-the-field work, on-the-field work, and it's a really great event done by Student Sports, who does a wonderful job promoting the youth and getting instruction to some of the best in the country.
So I guess coming out of that event, I think a lot of the things that you included was a lot of highlights from both of the quarterbacks here at Alabama. Obviously, Paul Tyson and Talia got a lot of attention. Let's start with maybe the big news. It looks like Tua may be ahead of schedule a little bit with the throwing, because he looked pretty solid this weekend.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I think this is the first time that, anyone was able to really get a chance to see Tua in action. I mean, as you know, we didn't see a lot of him during spring. He missed a day. And, from what I saw, there was zero limitation on his throwing motion. He looked absolutely phenomenal through the 3 days at the Elite 11. He's just so polished. And I heard many times Trent Dilfer say that Tua throws an NFL-type ball. And I heard he was also compared to Russell Wilson, just a left-handed version, in a sense. He's got extremely powerful legs. And honestly, Ryan, this is the best that I've ever seen Tua, and that includes last year. I think what we're seeing with him just continues to be something very special. And he's just so talented. And in fact, a user on Twitter put it best after I'd put some highlights up. You can watch those highlights on our Alabama football channel. He said this: it's like watching Ken Griffey swing the bat in terms of Tua throwing the football. I mean, it's just pure beauty. He threw for, had to throw over 100 balls during the weekend on the money, whether it was a 25-yard fade, a 40-yard bomb across the field. I mean, everything that you want, Tua just continues to deliver, and no limitations. He's ready to go, and he's 100% going to be ready for fall camp.
Yeah, simply go into YouTube. If you want to go and watch the videos, you can go and watch the Tua Tungo-Vailoa highlights, Jalen Hurts highlights, Paul Tyson highlights, Talia Tungo-Vailoa talking about his older brother there at the Elite 11. Simply go to YouTube. If you'll type in Bama Insider, it will come up, and you can join all those thousands of Alabama fans who subscribe to that channel. They get a lot of updates there, a lot of exclusive little interviews there. Kyle, let me go back here to a just observation. Could you even tell by looking at the hand that it was swollen? I mean, did it look normal to you?
I mean, I got an interview with him, so I was up close and talked with him, and he's 100% healthy. I mean, they did a fantastic job getting him back to where he needs to be. I wouldn't even talk about the injury anymore going forward. I think it's closed. What happened in spring seems to be kind of a freak deal with Tua, but he's 100% healthy. And the way he was spinning the rock, Alabama football fans should be extremely excited, because he's a big-time quarterback that's certainly going to deliver. He's got great accuracy, great zip, wonderful touch. I mean, kind of the list just goes on and on. And it was really exciting to see him at the Elite 11. I mean, he just looked so polished.
And you see some NFL analysts even offering their opinions, guys that do the living for NFL.com. I think Daniel Jeremiah had a comment and said, this guy is a left-handed version. I think you've already mentioned this. Russell Wilson. He's that type of player. I mean, the spin, I don't know who gave you the Ken Griffey analysis, but it's absolutely spot on because I never thought about it, but it was that swing of Ken Griffey Jr., and it's that throw of Tua Tagovailoa.
Yeah, exactly. Perfect. He's just a natural thrower, and it's just really beautiful when it comes off. And one of the things that I really like about Tua is just, and I talked with him a little bit about that, and he said when he was at the Elite 11, one thing that they really drilled the players about was going through the progressional read. So, whether that's 1, 2, 3, 4, and even 5 receivers sometimes, just his ability to really zone in on his correct progression and make that big-time throw. And we saw that all weekend from him.
Were they throwing against air? Were they just throwing against receivers and no defensive backs, right?
Yeah, they were. So what they did was a kind of a pro day deal. So this was for the college counselors and the 2019 quarterback. So you would start at the 10-yard line, and you would work all the way up the field, so 90 yards, and you would have to hit various routes, and you would be gauged on your accuracy, your delivery, and how quick you got the football off. I don't think Jalen or Tua won the actual event, but they actually bolted well, and especially Jalen. I mean, he struggled on day one of the event, but day two, I mean, he looked really, really good. And I think I'm not just saying that. I mean, you can read some other NFL analysts' opinion. I mean, he had a very big day two and three.
You know, Kyle, as you're sitting here talking about that, I wanted to segue over to Jalen Hurts for just a couple of minutes. Was it something that maybe he adjusted, or maybe what made him look better just by judging from what you were able to see? Was there anything he did different that maybe allowed him to be a little smoother than what we've seen in the past?
Yeah, I think so. During this pro day, which they had, this was Saturday night when, like I just said, they worked up and down the field, and Jalen was on fire. I mean, he was hitting every single target. He was very accurate, and he was accurate even on the deep ball. And I know we've talked about that again and again, but he's just such a competitor. And, I don't think he's, with all this hype of just everyone just wants Tua to be the quarterback, man, that's really encouraged him to work on his craft. And I think we saw a lot of improvement from Jalen. I was really excited to see what he delivered on Saturday night because he was he had a lot of energy. He was really bringing it. He threw a pass that was 35, 40 yards, right on the money. Everybody was wowed in the crowd. He continued to work up and down the field, hitting 15-yard outs, hitting fade routes. I mean, he was right on the money. I mean, he had a very good night. And you can watch those highlights. I mean, they're right there. And he was he had a really big night, and I think a lot of people should be excited about, his improvement because I certainly saw something different, even from A-Day. I think that even from April 21st to now, I think I've seen a lot of improvement from him. So he's certainly been working on his craft.
I mean, before we move to Talia and Paul Tyson, I mean, I'm excited because I feel like we've had this waiting game, right? We wanted 15 days of Alabama quarterback competition, right? I mean, that's what we wanted in the spring. And we didn't get that because of day number one and the injury. Now it seems like if everything goes as on course, we're going to get that in the spring. And I think that's the spring in fall camp, the end of July, 1st of August. We're finally going to get something that we've always kind of wanted is this 15 days and even more now leading into that first game against Louisville.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, I think the quarterback battle is really going to heat up and it's going to be eager to see these two quarterbacks really go at each other. And really work for that starting position because they both look very polished. And as I mentioned, I could not be more thrilled with what I saw from Tua. And, I mean, he looked fantastic. And I saw a lot of improvement from Jalen. So, it's about that time. Let's let these guys go at it and, have Nick Saban determine, who's the best, for the position.
Let me ask you about Paul Tyson. What'd you see from Paul Tyson, Coach Bryant's great-grandson?
Yeah, well, first of all, wonderful social skills. I mean, what he's like speaking to, a 30-year-old man. I mean, he's just so well groomed. He's a leader. I could tell just by the receivers that he was working with. They did a 7-on-7 on the final day, which was Sunday, And just the players, how they rally around him. These weren't his teammates. These were players from Long Beach Poly High School who are his receivers just for that day. And you could just tell they really responded well to him. Paul Tyson, really impressed. I mean, he's a big kid, 6'4", 210, 215 pounds. Big delivery, strong arm. Threw two big touchdown passes kind of at the end of that 7-on-7 period. I think he's a long ways away from stepping onto a college field and starting, but I certainly think, you know, he hung with the top high school quarterbacks at the event out of the 24. Now, he didn't make the finals, but I don't think that's a knock. I mean, he certainly competed very well, nothing to hang his head about, and I think he's going to have a big season. And one particular thing about Paul is he is spearheading this 2019 class. He's going after other high-profile targets. Him and Pierce Quick are kind of the leaders of that 2019 class. So you're going to see on social media that Paul Tyson and Pierce Quick are the ones really going after these other 4- and 5-star to really make this class of 2019 stay number one in the country.
Going to Talia here, what'd you see from this young man?
Oh, wow. I really like Talia. What a great kid. And, you know, I mean, those Hawaiians can spin the football because he throws a very tight football, very accurate. And honestly, I think he has a little bit more power than Paul Tyson. I think Talia had the edge in day one. In day two, they were probably a little bit similar. But I think on day three, Talia kind of pulled a little bit ahead and he was selected for the Nike opening, which is a really big honor for him. And he gets to follow in his brother's footsteps because his brother was also a member of, you know, the top caliber Elite 11. So, you know, he's the difference with him and Tua is obviously he's right-handed. Tua's left-handed. And he's smaller in stature. So what is Tua weigh, like 220, 225 maybe?
He's thick.
So Talia is a lot. He's working at the college level, but just trying to do that. And he throws a really good football, works through his progression really well. Can lay the deep ball, the out route. He's a really competitive quarterback. And I just like him and Paul, just wonderful kids as well. I just, you know, hats off to their parents because those kids are really raised right. They got good moxie. And I was just really impressed with what they each brought this weekend.
Yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun. I guess we're talking about what quarterback competition of 2018. But then the future competition, maybe like, what, 2021, 2022,
oh,
right?
Yep. Yeah, those guys are going to certainly battle in the next couple of years for that starting position. And it'll be fun to see Tagovailoa and the great-grandson of Bear Bryant go at it in a couple of years.
Hey, let me ask you about recruiting because it seems to be a huge priority for Alabama. And we've even watched them taking it to the streets with a social network. So not only recruits are kind of sending that message out, seems like a lot of coaches, a lot of social network changes, maybe a more aggressive approach from Alabama here in recruiting.
Yeah, I absolutely think so. And I think a lot has to do with the younger coaching staff, right? Like new guys getting in, Pete Golden, Brent Key, Josh Gaddis, those guys really hitting it hard on social media. And I think that's one of the things that, you know, was missing last year. I mean, obviously the guys last year on the staff did a fantastic job, but now you're seeing these guys really work social media. And as you know, that's where the recruits are. That's where the guys are at. And they need to see that Alabama football, you know, it can be youthful, can be playful, can get stranded on a boat and smile, you know, but at the same time, live in the weight room, be beast mode, and outwork yesterday. So I really like what this new coaching staff is bringing on the social media game. It's hot, it's exciting, and, you know, it keeps you thirsty for more Alabama football.
Yeah, 89 days away. Something tells me the forums there are beginning to pick up, the Talk of Champions, the recruiting board, the open forum, because people are, you know, I mean, we're beginning. I mean, like, we got an email earlier today about SEC Media Day credentials. And I know that's not much to anybody else, but it just kind of gives us the theme that we're getting to crunch point because we better get our vacations in order because we're just, you know, about a month away. Away a little bit more than a month, maybe 5 weeks away from SEC Media Days and about 7 weeks away from fall camp. So we're starting to kind of get in that anticipation of college football season. Give us a big plug for BamaInsider.com, the Rivals network of websites.
Yeah, so you can come on over to BamaInsider.com anytime. You can look for the 30-day trial. Andrew Bone is our recruiting analyst. I think he's one of the best in the business. You know, Tony Sukalis is a young team writer who does exceptional work. I mean, his writing skills you know, compare with some of the best. And I kind of oversee a lot of the different aspects. We have a very popular YouTube channel, tons of media coverage. And like everybody in this business, I think everybody does, you know, their best job to provide the best Alabama football content. And as you know, with the football season just on the horizon, there's no better time to go on over to BamaInsider.com and get your daily nuggets on Alabama football news and recruiting. So if you have any account questions as well, just email me. My email is Kyle@BamaInsider.com. Customer service is of a top priority. So be sure and reach out to me any single time. And, you know, always here to talk Alabama football. Love living in Tuscaloosa. And, you know, it's a great place. I mean, remember, I'm from Albuquerque, New Mexico. So it's a big jump from Albuquerque now living in the South. But I love the grits. I love the crawfish and, you know, all about Tuscaloosa.
Thank you, Kyle, man. I appreciate your energy. I always enjoy the conversations. We'll talk again, but great work out of the Elite 11 camp. I enjoyed a lot of the coverage that you provided there, YouTube channel and on BamaInsider.com. Thank you again, Kyle. Have a great afternoon, sir.
Thank you very much.